September 13th, 1944, after dinner. My beloved, this is only a note to tell you how much I love you. We have had dinner, and there was nothing spirituous to drink, the celebration having out-cleaned us and no new alcoholic centers taken. There are lots of troops around tonight and can sleep without challenging or throwing one's true love out of bed. I am just happy and purring like an old jungle beast because I love you and you love me. I am committed, so take good care of you for me and for us, and we will fight the best one we or anyone could ever fight, for what we spoke about, against loneliness, injustice, substitutions, all fear and many other worthless things, and in favor of you sitting up straight in bed, lovelier than any figurehead on the finest, tallest ship that ever drew on canvas or heeled over to a whim, and in favor of kindness, permanence, loving each other in fine, loving nights and days in bed. I love you very much and am your partner, friend, and true love. It is not so cold tonight, but the poor dog is so sad. I try to explain about things to him, but the dog knows he should handle the cattle and the pigs and loves his master. He knows I'm good, but all his world has gone to pieces, and he lies out in the barn and is heartbroken. I've had the cows milked so they do not hurt and fed the cat, but it is very sad about the dog. I've had the place all cleaned up, though that will not last. I wish the people would come back and take care of their dog. They are worthless and selfish to go away like that and don't deserve such a fine dog. Dearest Mary, please love me very much and always take care of me, small friend, the way small friends take care of big friends, high in the sky, shining and beautiful. Oh, Mary, darling, I love you very much.